Dear Mr. Crosby, I've been a fan of your music for many years. How do you keep soup off your mustache? With a napkin, same as you. Mustache just appeared there on my lip, and I kind of like it. So the truth is I get soup all over it. I'll tell you a story. My son James saw me with food on my shirt again and said, oh, you Crosby'd yourself. And at that point, since the whole crew and band were there, it became a verb, to Crosby yourself. So now every time anybody sees any of us with food all over our front, you know, oh, you Crosby'd yourself. I'm not happy about him doing that. Does CBD actually work? I hear it's searched more often than porn and Kanye West. Have you tried it? Yes, it does work. It's a mild analgesic. It's not a strong painkiller, but it is a painkiller. And it's a pretty good anti-inflammatory. The pharmacy companies, whom I don't trust at all, but once they purify it, concentrate it, you know, package it so that they can drop a pill on you that affects you the way an ibuprofen, you know, 800 does, and doesn't have any side effects, that could be even bigger than the getting high part of marijuana, because everybody's got pain. Everybody I know, anyway. All of us old people do, that's for sure. Dear David, my husband had prostate surgery a few years ago and it can no longer get it up, no matter what he does. It just hangs there like a piece of loose taffy. He has also completely lost his sex drive. Would I be wrong to seek sex outside of my marriage? I don't want to divorce the guy. He's the love of my life, but I'd also like to get laid. I can't solve that for you. Now, he can't help it that he got sick and that they had to operate on him and that his dick no longer works. Not really his fault. I don't know, talk it over with him. I don't know your relationship with your old man. If he tells you that you should go get laid, I think he's being noble and it will probably hurt him anyway. But if he tells you that, then you could. If you just do it on your own, yeah, you're doing the same thing he would have done going to a teddy bar. It's disloyal. It's not loving. Getting laid isn't that important. And I say that as a guy who, it was my main thing in life. I was a caboose to my dick. I followed it around. But it doesn't turn out to have been the right thing to do. Croz, I'm a high school senior with my whole life ahead of me, but the future I'm being handed seems so bleak. Donald Trump is president, climate change is destroying the planet, and everywhere I look, people are addicted to opioids or their cell phones. Am I just being a pessimist? Do I have a lot to look forward to considering everything happening in the world right now? I talk to a lot of young people on the net and personally, and there are a lot of people very discouraged with how things are right now. I'll tell you a scary thing. A lot of the young people I know are not planning families. A lot of kids aren't really even planning a future. They're not trying to get a career. They're not trying to get ahead. They're not trying to figure out their path in life. A lot of them don't think we're going to make it. I see the idiocy that's going on in Washington. I see people like Mitch McConnell, who I would love to just turn into a turtle. This is all discouraging stuff. It's discouraging to see our president openly pour gasoline on the fire of racism all the time. He is a racist. The idea that Amazon doesn't pay any taxes? Are you freaking kidding me? It's tough for any young person that I know to look at the world and feel like there's a good future there. And I'm discouraged too. I'm having to work hard to keep my head above water. But I think that's the answer. You can't really fight them if you are so discouraged that you give up. So you have to sort of believe that we can still do something in this world to make things better. I think the kind of young person that you may want to try and be is Greta Thunberg. Greta Thunberg is the most inspiring young person I know. You might want to try and emulate her. Stand up for what you believe in. That'll feel good. And get out in the street. That's what all the rest of us have to do. Protest.